Hello everyone, welcome to part 6 of our productivity demo, Microsoft OneNote Basics and Beyond. This is the last segment of our productivity demo, so please go back and check out our other videos on this topic. Or you can find other events and videos at microsoft.com/IT Showcase. And now, on to part 6.
Now, I've saved out my OneDrive for business. I've saved out my OneNote out to my OneDrive for business. Now I want to share it. So with the ability to store it out there comes the ability to share. How do we share our OneNote notebooks? If we were to click up on File and then go to Share, you can see right now it says Share with People, and right now you'll see the default right down here is shared with Brian Patrick, which is my middle name. So there it is, Brian Patrick. I am the owner, and you can see right now by default it is only shared with me. So that's one fear I want to ease of yours, that, oh, I've moved it out to a cloud location, it's automatically going to be visible by anyone and everyone on the internet. That is not the case. I have permissions to this notebook to then share out with specific people. Because I'm the owner, I'm the only one that can share out this notebook as well. So if I were to share this with my wife, I can give her edit access. She is not the owner, so she can't share it with anyone else. She only has the ability to go in and edit, add, and remove items. So in this case, I'm going to go in and add in my wife's email. So she's had this for a long time. I'll add in her email address, and I can give her edit or view access, and then I can click share. What that will do is that will share automatically my OneNote notebook with my wife. So now, not only does she have access to it and I have access to it, you can see she'll show up on the right-hand side. At any time, I can go and remove access as needed. So I'm back to my OneNote notebook. She has access to this OneNote notebook. She can go add in any items later on. Now, something that comes up with having a shared OneNote notebook is lots of people going in and making edits at a time. Lots of changes being made, items being removed, pages being deleted. This is the same for, even if it's your personal notebook, if it's your work notebook, we run into the same problems of, people going in and making changes without clarifying them first. In that case, OneNote keeps track of this for us, which is super. So in OneNote, now that we have a shared OneNote notebook, along the top, you can see right next to Draw, we have the ability to go in and access history. If I click on History, I can see all the items' history. So right now, we created this brand new OneNote notebook from scratch, so really there's no history, right? I've created each of these pages fresh. There's only been one version of each of these pages. But let's go up to this Work-Life Productivity Online Toolkit that we have created internally. So this is one that we used several years ago, and it's no longer in production, but this is a great example because it has a lot of history for us. In this case, you can see if I select on each one of these pages, I can then select on page versions. So in just a second, it will show up. Sorry about that. All right, let's go down to the WorkSmart experience. So it should have page versions. So unless all page versions were deleted. So in this case, let me go back to the WorkSmart. There we go. So now on the History tab within this WorkSmart notebook, I can see that there are page versions on this page. And the same thing should be the case for, and now it's coming through, is this Work-Life Productivity Online Toolkit. Each of these pages has page versions. So if I select on a page, I can go back and see, oh wait, something was deleted from here that was really important, and it wasn't clarified with me first. In that case, I could select on the page and then click on page versions. What's really nice is that underneath that page, it keeps a running history for us. So you can see all the way back in August of 2015, a change was made to this page. If I want to go through and see what that change was, I can select on that item and see that all the highlighted items in green were brand new to this page. So that's probably because this was a brand new page that we created and all those items were dropped in there. But I can go through and click on each one of these pages and see what was brand new. So if it's highlighted green, that means that there are that was the new item that was included. So this comes in really handy in a shared notebook environment. Now, again, with great power comes great responsibility, right? We've shared out these items and everyone has access to it. Well, the problem with that is we get lots of hands into a single location, lots of changes are going to be made. The benefit of OneNote is that it keeps track of those changes for us and we can always revert back to a previous item. So in this case, let's say items were overwritten on 224 rather than overwrote those changes we made on 29. We can always restore back this version by right-clicking on that page and then restoring it as the latest version. So again, you can always go back and reference it. What's really nice about each of these notebooks as well is the ability to identify when new items have been added to a OneNote notebook. If you look along the left-hand side of my notebooks, you can see that there are some notebooks that are highlighted or bold and others that are not bold. That's how we can easily identify when a notebook has new information. So in this case, I can see that Brian's notebook personal, Brian's work, and SuccessFactors SOP has new information. That's because it's bold. If I wanted to go through and see what new items were included in there, I could then click on each of those notebooks and identify what's new. What's also nice as well is within OneNote, if I were to click on a notebook that has new items, maybe it's bold. In this case, each of the sections that have new content would be bold as well as the pages. So I can identify the individual page that has new content directly just from looking at it from this screen. Now, if I don't want to go through all that work, maybe it's down deeper into a couple of the sections, I could always go through and click on Next Unread. Well, you can see right now that within this notebook, I've read everything. But I could easily click on Next Unread and go to that next item that is new to the OneNote notebook. I can also go through, and if I don't want to even go through and check all those items, you know, I just want to start fresh, I can always go through and mark as read. So just the same thing that we do within Outlook, how we can mark all of our emails as read, we can do the same thing within OneNote, we can mark all items as read as well. Now again, one of the really neat things within OneNote, again, is it tracks our history for us. So we can always go back later on, in this case, let's say it's this family notebook again, and I want to see the most recent changes that were made. In this case, I can go through and check out the recent edits, and I can filter those recent edits by a certain time frame. So in this case, I'm going to say, let's see the recent edits for the last 7 days. Well, in this case, because it's a brand new notebook, every single one of the pages is going to be on the right-hand side. But I can see each of those items shows up on the right-hand side, and I could go through and click on each one of these to identify what was added. So I can see right here, birthday party shopping list. If I click on it, those items come up, food ideas. It will highlight everything in yellow, the new items that were added. So again, we can go through and see each of those edits that were made. You don't want to go through that, see the recent edits. Maybe you want to find them by a certain person. Maybe I don't want to see the items that I added. I want to see the items that my wife added. In that case, what I could always do is I could find by author. So each person that makes changes within the OneNote notebook, OneNote tracks that for us. And then you can see right here next to the pizza, popsicles, and soda, it has my name. If I hover over it, it has Brian Mooring. Now, right now, within this notebook, you will see that I am the only author. That's because I just shared the notebook and no edits have been made. But I could expand the list and see all the changes that Brian made directly. I could also search additional notebooks. So again, like within all of OneNote, you can change the scope of which you search. So right now, we're just searching this notebook, but we could easily search all notebooks. So you do have that ability as well. And you can see, again, we start to see more and more names appear on the right-hand side. That's because now it's going across all of my notebooks. The last thing I want to cover with history is this idea that we have this shared notebook location, we have a shared notebook, we're working it together, and maybe items were accidentally deleted. So maybe this budget page that we worked so hard on, we created this Excel spreadsheet, we have this nice chart, maybe it was accidentally deleted. What do we do with it now? It's not going to be in my recycle bin on my desktop, so where does it live? each OneNote notebook has its own recycle bin. So I'm on the Brian notebook. I can go into recycle bin. Just a second. It will refresh. If at any time your notebook is not syncing, you can always right-click on your notebook and then sync this notebook now, and it will sync up to the cloud and update the cloud with your latest information as well. While that's working through, it's syncing, I can go up here to the WorkSmart Experience notebook and just show you as an example. Here's the notebook recycle bin for this notebook. Now each notebook, again, has its own recycle bin. If I were to click on this notebook, I could see that any pages that were added would be in the deleted pages section. If a section was deleted, it would show up here and on the top as well. At any time, if I want to restore that, I would just right-click on that individual page and then click on Move or Copy. Now, when you click on Move or Copy, you can move it to a different section within your notebooks that you have open, or you can just move it back to that original spot. So in this case, maybe I want to move this to the Brian notebook. I can select that notebook from the list and then go into, let's say, shopping list, and I can click on Move. Now, if you click on Move, it will physically move that page to the new location. If you select Copy, it will create an exact copy in the new location. So you do have that ability as well. So if we go out to Brian's notebook where I just copied that page, it is now available in the shopping list, and here it is. That's that page that we were able to copy out to our notebook. So last thing I want to talk about is the ability to, review. So again, like all Microsoft products, we have built-in spell check and we have the thesaurus, but we also have research available as well. So take full advantage of these incorporated tools that we have with OneNote, because again, it provides you a lot more benefits than just just randomly assuming that you spelled the things correctly, which in most cases I did not. So in this case, you could always run your spell check just like you do within Word and PowerPoint and all your additional Office products as well. Probably my most favorite though aspect of OneNote, and I know we're getting close to our time. So my favorite feature within OneNote is this idea of linked notes. So you can see right here on review, on the far right, we have this ability to create linked notes. Now, why would we do this? I've used this several times within research projects, and again, even for family time, researching vacations, this idea of creating linked notes to a location. So we could use the web, we could link notes to that website, we could link notes to a PowerPoint. So in this case, because I have a PowerPoint open, I'm going to click on linked notes. What I can do is I can click on a certain location, which I definitely want it to be within my Brian's notebook and untitled page, so I'm going to click OK. So now what I'm going to do is I have the PowerPoint open along this left-hand side. So I can say these are my linked notes. So access. And then as I start to type, you'll see a little window pop up on the screen. It says, we'll automatically create links in your notes to the documents or web pages. Now, why would I do that? So I'm going to click OK just to show you the benefits of having this. So I'm going to say access from any device is really important. And then we can go to this next slide, share and collaborate, which we already covered. We can say sharing and collaboration is one of the main benefits of OneNote. Now again, I misspelled. Anytime I can right click on it and spell it correctly. So there we go, we've changed it to sharing. So now I'm going to expand this out to be the full screen again. Now the real benefits of having those linked notes, you can see as we hover over access from any device, you'll see a little PowerPoint icon appear. Well, if I hover over that PowerPoint icon, it will actually show that exact page that we were referencing. So again, really beneficial if we're going to multiple sites, multiple pages, referencing different documents. I can easily navigate back to those pages just by hovering over my notes at that time. Oh, there, we were talking about this page. I can click on the file directly from this location, click OK, and it will open up that page directly. Thank you very much for coming today. I hope you at least found a couple of tips you can start to use with your OneNote usage. Again, it's one of my favorite tools because not only can I use it to manage my work life, but my home life as well. And the real benefit of having OneNote is the ability to have multiple notebooks open at a time. So not only can you have one on your hard drive, on your OneDrive, on your personal OneDrive, on your OneDrive for business, on a SharePoint site, you can have all these locations just in one single view. So again, super helpful to be able to navigate to each of these. Thank you very much for coming, and I hope you had a good time. Thank you.
We're at the end of part 6. We hope you enjoyed this productivity demo. IT Showcase has events scheduled every month where you can get your questions answered live. We hope you'll join us again and bring your colleagues. You can find our schedule of upcoming events as well as on-demand videos and other content at Microsoft.com/IT Showcase. Thanks again.